Good evening, everybody. I'm Krista Megan, many of you know, U.S. Air Force veteran of 9 years, loudmouth liberty lover and enforcer. It's been a while since I've done a video, but after watching the footage yesterday presented by Pete Santilli, which has been occurring at the Bundy Ranch in Nevada, I am compelled to let you know how pissed off I am. A lot of people are offended when I call the U.S. military the largest terrorist organization in the world. By definition, using violence or force to change government political agendas is terrorism. When the U.S. military goes overseas, oppresses the people, disguised as humanitarian efforts, all the while you don't realize it's to steal resources. We have oppressed other nations. Many of you have not read the book, Confessions of an Economic Hitman, but I would highly recommend it. Again, I'm going to tell you, the U.S. military is the largest terrorist organization in this world. While that may not sit well with you and you think of me as unpatriotic or anti-American, quite the contrary. I love my country. I love what my forefathers have done before me, not everything, but I appreciate what has been done to grant us and give us the liberties that we have left, and even those that have been taken away. Why I consider myself a lover of this country, I am not a lover of our government. Our government has been a tyrannical force hijacked by the UN and the big banks. If you are not familiar with what's been going on at the Bundy Ranch in Nevada, you really need to look at the alternative media. You have a family who has owned land, and this land has now been hijacked by some unconstitutional federal organization, the Bureau of Land Management, who thinks they can go in and steal cattle, attempt to sell it, or slaughter them, all the while disguised as trying to conserve grazing rights for some semi-extinct tortoise. For a government who loves our environment and animals so much, I'd really like them to answer for all the toxic waste that is dumped into our air, food, and water. So what you need to realize, veterans, active duty, any government official who has ever taken an oath, you need to really look at terrorism. What we are doing in Nevada right now, we are oppressing a man and his family and the supporters for resources. Folks, this isn't about a tortoise. This isn't about environmental tree hugger rights. This is about UN Agenda 21 land grab. If you're not familiar with what UN Agenda 21 is, you really need to look into it. This is about resources once again. So if you're dumb enough to go to foreign lands and think that you're a hero by going over there unconstitutionally, stepping foot on foreign soil without congressional approval, why are you not responding to the domestic terrorists who are just thugs for hire? Where are you? Why are you not in Nevada? If you're stationed in Nevada or near Nevada, why are you not asking your officials, why are we not going to defend this form of terrorism? You took an oath, and then that oath had told you to protect this country from enemies both foreign and domestic. Every speech class I've ever taken, every English class I've ever taken, has always told you, leave your boldest statement at the end. And in that oath, domestic comes second. Maybe you can't go to Nevada for financial reasons. Maybe you can't go to Nevada for medical reasons. Maybe you can't go just because it affects your livelihood right now. And if you cannot do that, the least you can do is share the information, the unbiased, live information that's being reported to you from people like Pete Santilli, Adam Kokesh, Alex Jones, RT, even Fox News. You may not be fans of all of these or any of these, but these are the news outlets that are actually covering it, still letting America know what's going on, and that should incite you to do your own research. Please inspire others to share this information. I really feel this is a true test to see what American patriots, whether you like that word or not, that's what I call it, to see what we will do, what we will take. They are going to provoke us with violence. But we can stand there with our Second Amendment rights. We can stand there with our freedom of speech, which is not an area. We can use the non-aggression principle to stand our ground. You only use violence as violence is used against you as a form of self-defense. Do not give these people a reason. But please, remember, we have domestic terrorists, and many of them are federal employees.